In this video, I'm going to show you how you can start a timer trigger based on the interaction of a user. All and more coming up. Hey then, welcome back to another video of measureschool.com, teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today we want to talk about the timer trigger. Now, the timer trigger is something that is built into Google Tag Manager. I don't often use it because you can really just utilize it when a user comes to the page, starts a timer, and then after a few seconds, you can fire your tag. So the use case is really limited because we cannot control when the timer trigger actually starts. So today I want to show you a workaround where we're going to build our own timer trigger that we can start based on the interaction of the user. That is particularly useful if you have, for example, some message that you send off and then a error or success message appears after 2 seconds. You want to start the timer and then check the element if there is a success or error message. That's exactly what we're going to do today, and we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. For our little demo here, I have found a code pen by Emmanuel who has come up with this little send button here that either shows a success or an error message after 2 seconds if we click it. Now I've modified this a little bit to build in Google Tag Manager, and when I click the send button, you see I've already built in a click trigger that gives us this event here. Now, our case here is we want to detect whether there's an error or success message after we click the button. But obviously, as you see, it takes a while for the success or error message to display. It's actually 2 seconds to be exact. Now, you could take this as an example of sending off a request, sending off a validation, getting something back from the server, which just takes a while. You wouldn't actually know, but approximately, you know the time that it would take till the user gets shown the error or success message. So how can we track this with Google Tag Manager? Just to demonstrate, if we would use the built-in timer trigger here, let's go over and build one of these timer triggers down here. We can set up the event name that should be pushed into the data layer, the interval, so that would be the time in milliseconds. In our case, let's go with 2.5 seconds. And the limit, how often it should repeat counting, in our case, just one. And then you need to choose the condition when it should be deployed. In our case, when the page host name contains CodePen, it should be fine. And we'll fire this on all timers for now. Let's save this and refresh, go back to our page. And we see the problem. After 2 seconds, we have our GTM timer in here, but we have no way of starting the timer again or having it start on an interaction. The only interaction that we can start this on is the actual page view. So once this event loads, the GTM timer will start counting. Not very useful in our case because we never know when the user will actually click that send button. So we need to come up with a little workaround. First of all, we want to get the actual text of the button, and normally you would do this via a click variable that you have maybe activated, but in our case it wouldn't show anything, as when we click on this button the success or error message is not yet shown. So we would need to use a different technique. Luckily we have a variable available for this, which is the DOM element variable. So let's configure one. Under user defined variables, we'll go with our DOM element variable right here. And we would need to select the ID or a CSS selector. Now let's look at our button in the developer tools, and we can see we are lucky we have an ID. In most circumstances, you probably would use the CSS selector, but for our case, we could go with an ID. Just need to enter the ID, which is request. And we don't need to enter a attribute name. The attributes are right here, because we want to get the actual text right here, which is the default if you don't enter any attribute name. So we are fine on this side. Let's give this a name and save this and see what it says. So go back to the page, reload, and we should see in our events right here
at the timer, for example, that our button text is now sent. Really, on any other event, it would also be sent. Now, if I click this button, we have our GTM click, and we look into the variables, and we still see the send, which is unfortunate because at a later point, we actually want to recheck this variable. And exactly after 2 seconds, we want to recheck that variable to see what the contents actually is. Is it error or is it success? So now is where we can build our own timer trigger with the help of a custom HTML tag. It's pretty simple, really. We just need to fire a tag that waits 2 seconds and then deploys a data layer push. So let's go over to tags and configure this. We'll go with a new custom HTML tag where we're gonna write in some JavaScript. So we'll put this into a script tag. And we can use the built-in JavaScript function, which is setTimeout. Now this takes two parameters. One is a function that should be executed, and the other is the time in milliseconds. So when do we want to check this? Again, I will go with 2.5 seconds. Now inside of this function is where the magic happens. This is the code that we want to deploy after 2.5 seconds. In our case, we just want to have a data layer event so we can recheck our variable. Easy as that, we just push something into the data layer with our normal push command. And the data that we want to push in the data layer is an event with the key GTM timer. We could name this anything else, but GTM timer will do for now. A best practice is to always wrap your custom JavaScript in an iffy. Now an iffy is an immediately invoked function expression, which ensures that you don't pollute your global namespace. Really something that you should wrap your custom JavaScript inside of your custom HTML tags in. For this JavaScript, it wouldn't actually be so bad, but as a best practice, I always put my custom HTML in an iffy. Now let's give this a name. This is simply a listener for our 2 second timer and a trigger. Now the trigger is simply the button click. That's when we want to start the timer. So we'll choose our click trigger and save this. To not get mixed up, let's get rid of our timer trigger and refresh our preview and debug mode. Refresh our page. And no timer is firing. If I click send, we have our GTM click, and 2 seconds later, we should have our GTM timer in here. So we have a new event where we can definitively check our variables and see what the button text is. It's error. And therefore, we could send that back to our tracking tools such as Google Analytics or use that in our variable. Let's make an example of that. First of all, let's build a trigger of this event. This would be a custom trigger on our 2 second timer. All right, let's use our custom event here. We'll just simply enter our gtm.timer event that we had in our data layer. And we only want to turn this trigger true when the DOM button text contains success. Let's save this. And now we can use that trigger to fire a tag. Now, just for an example, let's go with a Google Analytics tag. This will be an event tag with successful button click. All right. We'll go with an event and it's a button click and success. You still need a tracking ID and just for a test that should do it. Let's get our trigger set up, save this and refresh back to our page. And send this off. We have our GTM timer and our tag doesn't fire. Now if I click again, we get a success message and our Google Analytics event successful button click has been deployed. So this is how you can get around the GTM timer only firing on the page view by building your own listener. I'm also gonna link up the HTML down below. Don't forget, if you wanna have this live on your website, you need to submit this as a version so it goes live on your website.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can build a timer trigger based on the interaction of the user and actually started when the user clicked on the button. Now you might be asking yourself, why didn't you use the element visibility trigger? Fair question. In this case, I would definitely use the element visibility trigger and try it out and see if it works. But I have encountered some cases where a client's websites, the appending of the new DOM element actually happened and the element visibility trigger wasn't able to pick that up. In this case, it would be useful to actually have such a timer trigger that can wait for a certain given time after the user has done his interaction and then check the DOM. And that's what we did in this video. So I hope this was useful to you and you encounter such a case at some point and then think back to that GTM timer trigger that we have built today. Now I'd love to hear from you. Do you have any more questions? Leave them in the comments down below. And as always, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to this channel because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.